In this tutorial, I want to share with you how to use Slido to create an interactive environment with your audience, be it on hybrid meetings or on physical meeting or on a virtual meeting, completely virtual. Engage your participant with live polls, Q&A, quizzes, word clouds, and many more, whether you meet in the office, online, or in between of these. So to get to hybrid, there are a series of things is incorporated with these apps. Very nice, and you can easily use your phone to navigate. Once you come to slido.com, you can also use your phone to answer questions or participate in the engagement. So to get to this Slido, all you need to do is to come to slide.do, Slido, and or you can go to slido.com. it will still bring you over here, so you can participate as a participant. If you have a joining code, usually after creating a particular presentation, you have to be given a joining code that you can use to invite your students, just like the way we have it in Kahoot. So let's get started for free. So you have two options over here. You can log in using your WebEx, or you can log in using your Google account, or you can sign up using your username and password. Okay, so you can create, you can type in your name, username, password, and repeat the password and what's your role. And once you are done, then you can be able to start using Slido. And as a participant, you just enter the code and you can join an existing event. So let's say I'm signing up with my Google account, and let me sign in and we'll meet on the other side. Okay, hello Epic, welcome Epic, and this is your first Slido. To run live polls, quizzes, and Q&A sessions, create your first event, unlimited and for free. So you can create from scratch or from templates or from present now very easily, and you can run Slido directly from your favorite tool over here. You can run it from Google Slide, Microsoft PowerPoint, Microsoft Teams, and WebEx. So these are new. Microsoft Teams and WebEx are quite new. So let's say we'll start from templates. You can choose between different kind of templates over here. You have all hands, you can check. You have team meetings, you can check over here. You can have trainings, you can check the templates, you can have online lecture, and you can have retrospective. So very easily you can select anyone of the templates, and you can easily use it for your own case. But for now, let's say we are starting from scratch. So you just click, you can say from scratch, and you have to give your Slido a name. So let's say we call it demo one. You can give it an exact name so that you can easily arrange accordingly, and then you can have the start date and end date. So assuming the whole game is starting on January 15th and is ending today, January 15th also, so no problem. So you can put in the event code, you can go with the default, or you can add something on your own. So this is the code that you use to invite your participants. All right, so invite collaborators very easily. Let's say we are inviting someone. Let's say we are inviting, you can see how the event dates work by clicking on this, and you can see create event, this is it, and then start January 15 and end January 15. So you can have a preview of how the whole idea is going to be. So you just click on create to create this particular Slido. Okay, so you can click over here, event created. This is the admin mode of Slido. You can now set up and manage your event here. Okay, so get started, and you have the option to try multiple choice of question, word cloud, quizzes, ratings, open text, and ranking. Okay, add poll from templates. You can always import from templates and add. So let's say we are going with multiple choice, and we can say the sum of 3 and 3 is, so put the answer. For example, answer 1 is 9, answer 2 is 4, answer 3 is 6, answer 4 is 2. So we have other bunch of settings over here. For example, mark correct answer, you can mark the correct answer, and you can mark, you can use multiple options. You can do enable poll description. Okay, so you can have to put, you have to put the poll description. So for example, let's say the correct answer, we have to mark correct answer, so we'll be given the opportunity to mark the correct answer. So the correct answer is 6. Okay, so you can see it here, 6, and it is marked. Okay, so you can save this. So this is our multiple choice. You can see, you can create the poll. So you have to join in as a participant with this code. So let's go to Slido. So let's go to slido.com, and you can see it over here. We can join by entering the code. So let me just enter the code 729272. 729272. So you click on enter, and you can see I just joined. Right, so you can see I've just joined, and this is the question that we just asked, and I say the answer is 6, and you can send. Very easy. There you can see the result, and this is how you can answer other questions as well. All right, so you can create a new poll, you can give it a name, next level, and you can have options. Let's say we ask English question. You can change from multiple choice to something else. So let's say we are changing it to ranking. What you like to ask, let's say arrange in accordance importance. Okay, so you add the options over here, importance. You can select this to make it random options, and you can put in poll description. So for example, you have to put in the options. So arrange in accordance with importance. Okay, slides, audience connection, eating, bathroom soap, and you can see a bunch of options. So it's going to arrange it according to importance, and it's going to randomize the options to rank. You can select it, you can put in the importance as you move, and you can drag and drop an image to make it much more lively and interesting. So you can save this, and you have a second question, and you can always come to Slido. So you can always come into Slido, and you can answer this question. Okay, so enter the code, and let's say 729272, and once you join, now you can answer the question. So let's say the sum of 3 and 3 is, okay, and you can see it has just come up 100%. Okay, so you can show correct answer, which is 6. So we are right. So this is how to create the polls. You can check out the audience Q&A, and you can check out analytics over here. Okay, so very easily you can follow the analytics and see what happens, whether you are gaining the audience or not, or whether you are passing the message or not. Okay, at the top here you can present easily. You can start your presentation. You can come to this small arrow. You can present in a new tab. You can present in full screen. You can copy the link and share with your friends and students. And then down here, you have the option to play from Google Slide, PowerPoint, and many more. Okay, you can learn how to present over here if you want. Once you present, the player or the student is going to join with his phone, and then he can play the game, just like I have just played for the two games just right now. And then you can check out the infographics, and you can export the results. Okay, very easily you can export the results. So you can always come back to the live polls, and you can create more poll, and then you can see the performance as well. So ladies and gentlemen, this is just a bit about how to create educational games to play, just like in Kahoot, but this time around in Slido. If you enjoyed this video, please remember to give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to always hit the subscribe and notification buttons to stay connected to this channel for more of our very, very useful videos. You can share your content by taking a link to participants, or downloading the QR code, or you can invite collaborators very easily. So I'll see you in my next video. Bye.